Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Now we'll start this session, post-lunch session. It will start with Dr. Smitha S. Mule. Please.
Good afternoon, everybody. And I especially thank Professor B. Ravi from IIT Bombay for suggesting my name for this forum. And then I also thank Dr. Baldev Raj for inviting me on this forum. So whatever we have been talking and speaking since morning and hearing, I think in BARC we have tried to practice all these ideas, and therefore I will be presenting the experiment and the programs developed by BARC. See, the title of the presentation is Nuclear Spin-offs for Inclusive Manufacturing and the Concepts of Akruti, RHRDF and Silage. So in my presentation I will detail out the acronyms. So BARC is R&D in nuclear energy. At BARC has not only generated a comprehensive Indian nuclear power program, but also has led to huge knowledge wealth in terms of large number of non-power applications and spin-off technologies, and also for societal and industrial benefits. This is a picture of various technologies which can be jotted down for societal and rural applications. There are many more technologies available on the BRC website, and HTTCD is can be contacted for desirous industries for taking the technology license from BRC. Some of the technology, I would say this is tele-ECG system. This is ECG can be captured at the rural level or the patient's table, and then it can be transmitted through mobile phone. Recently, NDTV has telecasted this system, and a lot of requests are now coming to BARC for taking the technology. There are other technologies like solar dryer, Nisargaruna biogas plant, soil testing kit, and hydrogel burn injury dressing, and many more. Isotope hydrology also, if Dr. Anil Joshi is there, he will know how we have done it in HESCO. So there are many technologies available with BRC, and now how to reach out to people, and constantly we were thinking on how to make these technologies available to desirous entrepreneurs, not only industry, but most of the technologies are also required in the villages to create non-farm activities, as well as for land improvement and electricity generation or cooking gas availability, good seed quality and manure quality, agro-processing technologies then and there itself. So while doing this exercise, as we all now have talked about, that there are many resources in the villages, that water, land, vegetable, fruit, crops, health, cattle, electricity, and main important thing is human resource. But these all village resources are scattered in 6 lakh villages and in state bits. Now Akruti is a program, that is, it's an acronym for Advanced Knowledge and Rural Technology Implementation. It is an initiative from the local people, and this Akruti program is complementing and augmenting the existing efforts of all other Government of India ministries and other R&D labs. So Akruti is a node or a place or a technology hub in the village, which when they sign agreement with BRC, we provide them a set of technologies, as you have just seen. And this advertisement is also available on BRC website under Akruti technology package. The technologies are provided in the concessional cost to the desirous entrepreneurs who want to set up the facility in a village. And so once an Akruti hub is formed there, now we were talking to initially to NGOs to try out this experiment. Obviously, Akruti cannot be inside the lab of BRC. We have to take help of some village NGOs. So the funding was given by Government of Maharashtra Science and Technology Commission, and we have proved that these uneducated villagers also can handle BRC technologies and can carry out a lot of innovations. And with this experience, we came out with the concept that instead of talking directly to villagers, we can also talk to the education institutes. There are many engineering colleges located in villages, and therefore engineering college becomes a knowledge partner to BARC, and it's a constant source of knowledge input to the villagers in the local region. So many faculties get involved, students get involved, and villagers also get involved, and they get knowledge in their own language. So creation of the training material and database generation and modifications in the basic know-how which they are getting from BRC is a addition from these college institutions. So this exercise was carried out, and now one engineering college in Gopalpur, Silej, Gopalpur place, that is Taluka Pandharpur and District Solapur in Maharashtra, it has been tried out. We have MOU with this engineering college, that is Sri Vitthal Education and Research Institute. You can see the engineering college has its own building, the hostel facility, the workshop facility, sports, nice sports facility. And this is the building which has come up now in its campus. And this building is called as Rural Human and Resource Development Facility. We have been hearing that this is a gap area. So exactly this is what we have already thought of, that let us have the facility to develop the rural resources and human resources, initially with the help of BRC technologies, and later all the technologies from any other R&D labs can be integrated in this program. So these are the various activities. We can see the Nisargona biogas plant. They have developed their own mechanisms how to run these biogas plants in their villages. Like they had some mechanism of carrying out the waste from agricultural waste from the various farmers in the plastic drums. It used to be brought to the college premises, and while after processing, the farmers were given the slurry of the biogas plant, which they will putting back into the soil. That is how soil improvement as well was taking place. And then there is a soil testing kit lab which has been set up in this campus RHRDF facility. So the villagers were then and there itself getting the analysis of their soils, the time otherwise they were spending in going to taluka level and the expenses they were giving. Now they're happily paying money to this facility. Similarly, this seeds, BRC has also developed good varieties, high yielding varieties and disease resistance varieties. So a seed bank has been, the concept of seed bank is being implemented by these RHRDF staff, and they grow the seeds and then they multiply and share amongst themselves. This is the groundnut variety they have started. It is a region of grapes and pomegranates. So they have developed this food drying facility for making raisins out of the grapes. This is the advanced automatic weather station which we have guided them how to procure, and now they are collecting the data. And this is tissue culture, banana tissue culture lab also has been set up, then workshop facility for fabrication of solar dryer and vibrothermal disinfestor. Vibrothermal disinfestor essentially is an alternative to chemical fumigation for storing of seeds or for storing of the grains, the pulses and grains. So these are the various activities, and there are many more. And since this is this, under the MOU, this is treated as a DI outreach center. So I am thankful to Dr. Chidambaram sir, who has facilitated to provide a national knowledge network connectivity to this place. And being NKN in its place, the college authorities have thought of expanding the network to surrounding 5 schools in villages through Wi-Fi. And therefore up to 20 to 25 kilometer distance schools got connected with this national knowledge network. And now even Dr. Ketki Bapat has been in the various conferences. We can see that how the colleges are interacting, the schools are interacting. See, you can see here that this is BRC, we are sitting here. This is Dr. Shri Krishna Gupta, my current head of the division, who is supporting this. Myself, Dr. Vishwas Kulkarni, our expert from banana tissue culture. Professor K.L. Ramkumar sir, who just retired. These are the farmers in the RHRDF building of Pandharpur. He is a farmer near to one of the school. Because school is having Wi-Fi, the farmers are also getting on their mobile. So they are showing the photographs of the crops and taking the guidance of BRC experts. This is laser-based land leveling system. You can see the uniform crop, which is because of laser land leveling system the farmers are getting. Soil testing is been carried out on the field itself by this RHRDF staff. And solar dryer is being very popular. They have at least developed many varieties. The many self-help groups have come forward, and they are regularly taking training in this RHRDF facility to take the training and standardize the processes for drying the local varieties. It may be even dhaniya, coriander leaves or kadi patta, even tomato they have dried, because tomato were thrown by the farmers. So that time the solar dryer has really helped them. And the tomato soup can be made easily out of that. It's a pomegranate region, so they are drying the aerials, and very nice dried pomegranates are being made. Skin of pomegranate has been dried, and it is a good for cosmetic product. So there are so many products they have developed, and this is how we say that this presence of rural human resource development facility in a place like Engineering College of Sweri, which has got pharmacy, PhD, undergraduate, postgraduate programs, and connectivity with surrounding 50 villages. This is the key point, sir. It has a connectivity of surrounding 50 villages. The students were coming from most of the villages, and faculty were also interested to interact with the villages. And therefore, this Gopalpur place has, with the training, it is treated as an outreach center as well as with the rural human resource development training facilities. It has now spreaded the various technologies in 50 villages, and it is also acting as center for enterprise promotion. And therefore, we call it as a Gopalpur Silage. Silage is nothing but a city-like opportunities in a village. We were morning discussing and talking about the same concept, whether villages can be made as a livable. So best of city, that is work opportunity in a village, has been introduced for creation of integrated work living environment in a rural sector, and that is the concept of silage. So there are faculties in this college who are actually graduated from South Carolina University and now working in this college. So this is the ecosystem providing complete environment for education. The rural education is there, then engineering education, as well as the knowledge, constant know-how from BARC is being provided, and NKN is there, high-speed broadband is there, training center is also there for interested villagers, and there are Akruti. Akruti is the ultimate aim for deployment and percolation of this R&D and technologies directly to the users. So this is how this whole concept is working in this place, and it's a great place for creativity and innovations. And there is a paper has been recently published in Current Science, which is a concept of knowledge and technology enabled empowerment of rural Indian villages in 25th February, which is authored by Dr. Anil Kakodkar. It is his vision which we have translated into developing these mechanisms. My earlier head of the division, Mr. M. Patankar, has really developed these mechanisms. I am the co-author in this paper. So you please go through this paper. I have a copy of this paper. Anybody interested can take up for me. So I am thankful to all of you who think that we have to apply new knowledge for creation of the society.